Hello everyone, myself Dr. Sunildatta N. Kulkarni, Assistant Professor, Mechanical Engineering Department, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. In continuation to my previous session on load curve, today I am going to deliver a video session on various types of load factors. The outcomes of this video session are, at the end of this session, students will be able to define the various terms related to power plant performance. Also, students will be able to explain the various terms related to power plant performance. The contents of this video session are definition of various types of load factors and their equations. Also, we are going to discuss the significance of various load factors. Firstly, we'll try to understand the various terms and definitions in connection with the power plant performance. The first term which we are going to discuss is the connected load. What do you mean by connected load? It represents the sum of ratings of all the equipments in kilowatt installed in the premises of a consumer and connected to power supply. Let us think, what do we mean by a connected load? Here, there can be a confusion about the connected load and load utilized. Whenever we consider, for example, let us consider the example of house. In house, we have various electrical equipments like lamps, fans, heaters, and various other electrical appliances like television, air conditioner, etc. Now, all these loads will have a definite ratings. And these ratings, when we add together, we get a connected load. Whether we use them or not, that is a different issue. But under connected load, it is the sum of all the ratings of all the equipments in kilowatt. Now let us see an example. For example, in a domestic accommodation, suppose following equipments are connected to power supply. Suppose we have electrical lamps of 100 watt in 6 numbers. We have fans, 4 numbers of 60 watt. Then we have tube lights, 2 numbers of 40 watt capacity. Then we have heater, 1 number having rating of 1000 watt. And electric iron, 1 number of 500 watt. Then cooler, 1 number of 300 watt. For calculating the connected load, we have to multiply by number of each equipment and its rating. So suppose here I have shown the calculation of 6 into 100 for electrical lamps, then 4 into 60 for fans, then 2 into 40 for tube lights, 1 into 1000 for heater, 1 into 500 for electric iron, and 1 into 300 for cooler. Then totally we will get the total connected load as 2720 watts, which will come out to be 2.72 kilowatts. Now this is called as the connected load. Now let us see, what do you mean by the maximum load? The maximum load demand represents the maximum load a consumer uses at any time. The maximum demand will be equal to connected load of a consumer if all the equipments and appliances are run parallelly to their fullest extent and simultaneously. However, in practice, all the devices are never run at full load and at the same time, due to which the maximum demand is usually less than the connected load. Now, average load. From the load curve, we can find out the average demand of all the consumers, which can be decided as, for example, if we consider a dairy load curve, then daily average load we can calculate by taking the area under the load curve, which is given expressed in terms of kilowatt hour, divided by time duration of a day, that is 24 hours. So by this we will get average load. Now let us see the next term, which is very important term related to the power plant performance, which is called as the load factor. The ratio of average load to the maximum load is called as the load factor. This load factor is required to be high. If the value of load factor is as close as to 1 or 100%, then we can say that the power plant is utilized economically. The lower value of load factor indicates that we are underutilizing the power plant. and therefore the load factor will be less. If we consider the annual load factor, then the kilowatt hour average in a year divided by kilowatt hour maximum utilized in a year. So kilowatt hour average in a year divided by kilowatt maximum, that is maximum load in a year, multiplied by hours of the year, that is 8760. This gives us the annual load factor. Similarly, another important factor is capacity factor or plant factor. It is defined as ratio of average demand supplied to an installation to the connected load of an installation. That is average load divided by rated capacity of the plant. Suppose if you want to calculate the capacity factor for on annual basis, then kilowatt hour, that is number of units of electrical energy generated in a year, divided by kilowatt hour installed, multiplied by hours of the year, that is 8760. This gives us the capacity factor. The difference between the load factor and the capacity factor is an indication of the reserve capacity. Now the next factor is reserve factor. It is the ratio of installed capacity to the peak load. Thus, the reserve factor can be expressed as kilowatt installed, that is total load installed, connected load, divided by kilowatt maximum that is being utilized. The reserve factor, if we consider the definition of load factor and capacity factor, and then if we divide the load factor by capacity factor, we get the same expression, that is kilowatt installed upon kilowatt maximum. Therefore, the reserve factor can also be expressed as the ratio of load factor upon capacity factor. The reserve factor of 1.2 to 1.25 is desirable, which means that installed capacity should be 1.2 to 1.25 times the peak load, so that the plant will not be overloaded. Now let us see the demand factor. It is the ratio of actual maximum demand to the total connected demand. So demand factor can be written as the ratio of maximum demand to the total connected demand. Usually maximum demand is always less than total connected demand. So demand factor in terms of equation we can write at kilowatt maximum divided by kilowatt connected. Now let us see the diversity factor. This is one of the very important term used in case of power plant performance. As we know that the consumers will be of various type, that is diversified type, like residential, industrial, commercial, etc. And therefore, we require to define the term called as diversity factor. It is defined as ratio of sum of individual maximum demands of the load to the maximum demand of the entire group of the loads at a given time. In equation form, we can write it as sum of the maximum individual demands of the consumer group to the actual maximum demand of the whole group. Here, when we say that maximum individual demands of the consumer group, means here we will consider the consumer group as residential group, commercial group, or industrial group, or any other consumer group, and their maximum individual demand divided by actual maximum demand of the whole group. This diversity factor help us to improve the load factor and economic operation of the plant. Diversity factor will be always greater than unity. Diversity factor helps us to run the power plant economically in such a manner that whenever we require the load which is equivalent to the average load, then we can operate the base load plant. Whereas for higher load, greater than the average load, we have to go for the peak load power plant operation. The plant use factor, it is obtained by modification in plant capacity factor by using only the actual number of hours of the plant which was in operation. So we can write the plant use factor as kilowatt hour generated divided by kilowatt hour installed into actual operating hours. So if operating time is 1 year, 8760 hour, then plant use factor will be equal to the plant capacity factor. But whenever we consider here the actual operating hour, then we call it as a plant use factor instead of calling it as a plant factor or capacity factor. These are the references. Thank you.